became flesh, living life among mankind. He saw man's depravity, the situation of their life. God in the flesh deeply felt man's helplessness.
Also attained through the word, know your own. to change his disposition.
We good to go?
We're ready.
And the props. Are you sleeping?
Director Shen is here.
We're about to start. We all know this is a key moment in welcoming the Lord's return.
It is.
But churches today are almost empty.
That's true.
Our brothers and sisters have lost faith, spiritually weak. It's hard to believe the desolation in the temple so long ago has reappeared today.
Why is that?
Are you asking me why? Obviously, I don't know. To remind everyone to look out for the appearance of the Lord Jesus, a warning from history, a sketch by our church, may help reaffirm their faith. Okay, let's get ready to shoot. Okay, all teams, get ready to roll.
Okay.
Director?
Yeah?
The Pharisee male lead has some issues at home. He can't be here.
Really? He really has incredible timing. This is the worst possible time. Where am I going to find a replacement?
Director?
The pastor is yes.
Pastor Zha.
Hey, Director. Why haven't you started filming anything yet?
Pastor Zha, the Pharisee male lead had something come up and now he can't make it. What should we do?
Well, what else? Find a replacement.
Look at the time. Where do we find one now?
Look at all these people here. Just grab one. You, come here.
Hey, Pastor. Not just anyone can perform the part of the Pharisee.
Why is that?
Well, he's a leader. He needs to know the Bible. But important, he needs to be a hypocrite.
That's a good point. No wonder I made you the director. But who's our replacement?
Oh, Pastor! I found our Pharisee!
You did?
Yeah!
Who is it? You?
You're the Pharisee!
You're calling me a Pharisee?
This mouth of mine. Pastor Zha, all I mean is that you're perfect for the part.
Well, then say what you mean.
So, you'll do it then?
Who, me?
Yeah?
No way.
No, Pastor, don't go. This is an emergency. Everyone is waiting to see our sketch.
I'm not prepared. How am I supposed to do this?
Huh? Come here, get a costume. Quick.
How will this work?
It'll be fine.
Pastor Jeff,
just be
yourself. You'll do great.
Great, we've found our Pharisee.
It's perfect.
Everyone, remember your lines.
Got it.
Everybody ready? Here we go.
Okay.
Ready? Action!
Hey, have you heard? Jesus resurrected Lazarus 4 days after his death.
Let's go.
Hey,
yes.
Jesus' miracles are exciting to the Jewish community.
That's true.
Everyone knows about it.
That's right. Some say he's the prophesied Messiah, the Christ.
Excuse me. Jesus couldn't possibly be the Christ.
Right.
How could the Christ not be born in Bethlehem?
Yeah.
Hey, I think Jesus must have been sent by God. Otherwise, how could he have such power?
I see you've been tricked as well. Do any of the rulers or Pharisees believe in him at all?
Right.
But right now, so many people say that Jesus is the prophesied Messiah.
Right.
I've also heard his sermons, and his words have great power.
Yes.
It's from the Holy Spirit and is the voice of God.
Hey, hold on. But the elders say he is a deceiver.
Exactly.
The Sanhedrin declared, any who recognize Jesus as Christ will be expelled.
Hey, the elder is here.
We'll talk to the elder about this.
Wow, I was right. He's a perfect Pharisee.
I have been told there are those who leave the temple to hear the sermons of Jesus of Nazareth. This is forbidden.
Forbidden?
Yes, forbidden.
Also, what's my line?
What do I do?
What's my line?
I forgot.
Huh, I know what I'll say. You hear preaching of the Lord Jesus' return, or new words expressed by God, or God's work of judgment beginning with the house of God. Never let yourself believe it.
Don't ever.
You must refuse to hear it,
or read it, or look into it.
Stop, stop, all wrong, all wrong. Come on, you're a Pharisee, not a pastor.
Yes.
Sorry.
You're getting distracted on stage.
Just a habit.
One more time. Remember, you're a Pharisee, okay?
Right, a Pharisee.
Yep. All right, everyone, get ready. Action.
Elder, fewer and fewer people are coming to the temple. Mm. More and more of the commoners are following Jesus. You have to think of something.
Right. If it goes on like this, everyone will follow and believe in him. Even the Romans will come to take our land and our people. Then we'll lose our powerful status and our tenure.
Yes.
Lose our what?
Shh. His job for life?
Do not fear. I have a way to stop them from following Jesus. My brothers, some preach that Jesus of Nazareth is the prophesied Messiah. Well, how could this be?
It's impossible.
It's impossible.
The scriptures say, what things soever I command you, observe to do it. You shall not add thereto, nor diminish from it.
Right.
Right.
Many of Jesus'
teachings
are not listed in the laws. He doesn't follow the law. He works on the Sabbath.
Exactly.
He goes far beyond the scriptures.
Yeah.
How could he be the prophesied Messiah? You must not follow him.
Right. Jesus and his disciples don't keep the Sabbath, and he sits at the table with sinners. Is that not a clear violation of the laws?
Yes. The law says eye for eye, tooth for tooth. But Jesus teaches, you resist not evil. But whoever shall smite you on your right cheek, turn to him the other also. Is this not adding to the law?
It is.
So think about that very carefully.
Right. Jehovah said, you shall not add thereto, nor diminish from it. Aren't Jesus' words adding to the law? He might be right.
Right? What's going on here?
I can't figure it out.
Jehovah said, you shall not add thereto, nor diminish from it. That was a requirement for men.
Right.
But we can't apply that requirement to God.
Right.
If we delimit God's work to the laws, aren't we being unreasonable? It makes sense that in a new age, God does new work and expresses new words.
That's right. God has a plan for his work and freedom to work as he pleases. All God does is the truth and is to save mankind. How can we use God's requirement of man to delimit God?
You can't talk like...
Delimit God? Ha! Ridiculous! We believe in God according to the scriptures. How could this be delimiting God?
Exactly.
Exactly.
God's words and work are all in the scriptures. There is no record of Jesus' words and deeds in the scriptures.
True.
They are outside the scriptures. How could they be the words of God? We believe in God only through the scriptures and the scriptures alone. Anything beyond the scriptures, we will not accept.
Amen.
Hey, I don't understand what you're saying that for.
What? What don't you understand?
Let me ask you. Is God's work limited by the scriptures?
Exactly.
Which came first, God's work or the scriptures?
Right.
Look at what you're asking. Of course God's work came first, followed by the scriptures.
Could work God hasn't done yet be recorded in advance?
Of course not.
No.
No.
You know that's impossible. Jesus brings a new age with new words and work.
Right.
How could those be recorded? In the Old Testament.
Exactly.
God is the true living God, God's work is always new and never old, and always progressing.
Amen.
But you are limiting God's footprint to his past words and work. This is restricting and resisting God.
Resisting?
Hey. What it is.
God's words and work may not all be recorded in the Old Testament, huh? But God's words are all recorded in the Old and New Testaments. The whole entire Bible. The whole Bible is God's testimony. Anything outside the Bible is not the words or work of God.
Pastor Ja is right. We cannot delimit God's words and work to the Old Testament. We have to delimit them to the Old and New Testaments.
Yeah, no,
that's more like it.
You can't say that.
Many of God's words were not compiled into the Bible.
Wrong again.
What?
Those lines aren't in the script at all.
They're not?
We're set in the age of law. What are you doing pulling out the modern Bible? Put it away, now! And you three, review your lines. Go, go. And you guys, you're completely losing the plot. Give me that script.
A new age. With new work. And new words expressed. That sounds a lot like the teachings of Eastern Lightning.
Oh.
Do you think they believe in Eastern Lightning?
Many good sheep from various sects are accepting Eastern Lightning. I think that they do.
Eastern Lightning's appearance is shaking every denomination and sect to the core. Lots of people are visiting the Church of Almighty God's website to learn more. There's no way to stop them. Pastor Ja, what should we do about this?
They want to steal my sheep. Not on my watch.
Right.
All right. It sounds like you believe in Eastern Lightning, don't you?
Don't you?
We're just looking into it.
Are you serious?
Please, Pastor Ja, we're filming a sketch here. Let's finish the sketch first.
My sheep are fleeing. I don't have time for this.
Our brothers and sisters are all...
What do I say to you every single day? Huh? Any teachings talking about the Lord's return are completely false.
Completely false.
I tell you not to seek or read about it. Why don't you listen?
Then how are we supposed to know if it's real?
It is not.
Yeah. Only Eastern Lightning publicly testifies that the Son of Man has come as the incarnate Almighty God.
That's right.
Issuing truth and doing judgment starting with the house of God. That fits perfectly with the Lord's prophecy.
Right. How can we ignore this?
Now, think about this, huh? Eastern Lightning testifies that the Lord has returned and has already expressed new words. There's no prophecy of that in the Bible.
Exactly.
Yes.
In the book of Revelation, it said, "If any man shall add to these things, God shall add to him the plagues that are written in this book."
Amen.
The Bible can't be added to or diminished. So, everything God says and does is in the Bible. If it's not in the Bible, it's not from God.
Right. God's words and work are all in the Bible. There are no new words or work that aren't in the Bible. Nothing is added. Get it?
Hey, why does that sound so familiar?
Pastor Ja, this prophecy isn't talking about the entire Bible.
Right.
Only about the book of Revelation.
Right.
So not adding anything is only a warning so things don't get carelessly added to God's prophecy. It doesn't mean there won't be any new words and work from God in the future.
Right.
Almighty God's work and words in the last days fulfill the prophecies in Revelation. You're saying it's adding to God's prophecy?
Right.
Can you promise that God won't express new words in the last days?
Right. Pastor Ja.
Oh, no. Can't you see? Pastor Ja wants to say something.
Yeah.
Pastor Ja.
Pastor Ja, calm down. Now go tell them how wrong they are.
Okay.
Yeah.
How many times have I told you? Huh? Don't interrupt others when they're speaking. Why won't you listen? We believers in the Lord need to be humble. Let them finish.
Okay, go. Brothers and sisters, the Lord Jesus clearly prophesied.
I have yet many things to say to you, but you cannot bear them now. However, when he, the Spirit of truth, The Spirit of truth is come. He will guide you into, He will guide you into all truth, into all truth. For He shall not speak of Himself, but whatever He shall hear, that shall He speak. And He will show you things to come. And He will show you things to come.
Revelations prophesies, the scroll opened by the Lamb. What the Spirit says to the churches, the hidden manna and seven thunders uttered their voices. These are all God's work and words in the last days.
Yet you say outside the Bible we can't find God's work and words.
Aren't you rejecting openly the words of the Lord? Aren't you denying the work of the Lord's return? You are judging the Lord. You're resisting the Lord.
Yeah? Isn't this condemning the work of the Lord Jesus' return?
Huh. Brothers and sisters,
don't believe in any new words, any new work. As long as we have the Bible, it's enough for us. The Bible stands for God. Faith in God is faith in Bible. Anything outside the Bible, anything outside it, I will not accept.
We do not accept any new words or new work. Our faith in the Lord is faith in Bible. We believe in nothing else, anything not in line with it. Even if Almighty God is the return Lord, we will not accept.
Hey, just now when we were performing, isn't that how the Pharisee resisted the Lord Jesus?
Yeah. Pastor Jia, does the Bible represent God? Is it God or the Bible that saves people? Do you pray to God or to the Bible?
Exactly.
I think that your stubborn adherence to the Bible and refusal to accept the return of the Lord Jesus is just like the Pharisees resisting the Lord Jesus.
Yes. The Lord Jesus once accused the Pharisees, "Search the Scriptures, for in them you think you have eternal life, and they are they which testify of me. And you will not come to me that you might have life." Pastor Jaw, you replace God with the Bible and preach the absurd theory that believing in God is believing in the Bible, and believing in the Bible is believing in God. Isn't that exactly what the Pharisees did? You think you're earning eternal life? Don't you think only Christ is the truth, the way, and the life?
Amen.
By following the footsteps of the Lamb, we can truly live. Almighty God's Word has power and authority. Reading it feels like you're face to face with God, and your heart knows that Almighty God's words are the voice of God, just like when we read the Lord Jesus' words. Except for God, whose words can achieve that effect?
That's right. There is so much to be found in Almighty God's Word. The Word appears in the flesh.
Yes.
It reveals God's management plan, contains words that judge mankind's corruption and rebelliousness.
Right.
It reveals the path for people to escape corruption and be purified, and tells us the final end and destination for each person.
Right.
These are all truths we must understand as believers in God.
Yes.
The more I read of Almighty God's Word, the more brightness I feel in my heart. I'm certain Almighty God's words are the truth and the voice of God.
Amen.
Isn't Almighty God truly the returned Lord Jesus?
What? Is the Lord, Jesus really back?
That was a really good argument.
Jesus is really back.
Are you kidding me? What they are testifying is not in the Bible, huh? If it's not in the Bible, we can't listen to
you
it.
You don't know? Right. Brothers and sisters, let's listen to Almighty God's word.
Yes.
Don't listen to Almighty God's word.
Yeah, don't do that.
Reading the Bible is enough for us.
Yes.
Wait, Pastor Jah. How can we know if Almighty God's words are the truth if we don't hear them?
Yeah. Why are you so scared of letting people hear Almighty God's word? What's so frightening about that?
Yeah.
Scared? Huh. I am not afraid. I'm a pastor. Read it.
Now, let's listen to the words of Almighty God.
Let's hear the words of Almighty God.
After all, which is greater, God or the Bible? Why must God's work be according to the Bible? Could it be that God has no right to exceed the Bible? Can God not depart from the Bible and do other work? Why did Jesus and his disciples not keep the Sabbath? If he were to keep the Sabbath and practice according to the commandments of the Old Testament, why did Jesus not keep the Sabbath after he came, but instead washed feet, covered head, broke bread, and drank wine? Isn't this all absent from the commandments of the Old Testament? If Jesus honored the Old Testament, why did he defy these doctrines? You should know which came first, God or the Bible. Being the Lord of the Sabbath, could he not also be the Lord of the Bible? Those who only care about the words of the Bible, who are unconcerned about the truth or seeking my footsteps, they are against me, for they limit me according to the Bible and constrain me within the Bible, and so are blasphemous in the extreme toward me. How could such people come before me? They pay no heed to my deeds, or my will, or the truth, but instead obsess over words, words that kill. How could such people be compatible with me?
Interesting reading from the Bible that was. Brothers and sisters, the Pharisees charged Lord Jesus with not abiding by the laws and not being the Messiah. They had him nailed to the cross, thereby committing a terrible sin. Their mistake should be a warning for each and every one of us.
That's right. If we do what the Pharisees did, reject and abandon God because God's new words are not in the Bible, then our end will be just like theirs.
That's right.
That makes sense. We should investigate Almighty God's work in the last days. We can't allow other people to deceive us by using the Bible to delimit and resist God.
Yes.
Right. If what Almighty God expresses is the truth, then he's without a doubt the return of the Lord Jesus. Because the Lord Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life."
Right. So let's go learn more about it.
Learn more?
I'm warning you. If anyone investigates Eastern Lightning, I'll expel them from the church.
You'll be expelled. And if anyone from Eastern Lightning comes to steal our sheep, we'll call sent to jail.
To jail. Are they still considered believers in God?
After today's sketch, I understand. The way the Pharisees resisted the Lord Jesus is the same way you resist and condemn Almighty God. There's absolutely no difference between you and the Pharisees.
You're not playing the part of Pharisees. You actually are modern-day Pharisees.
Modern-day Pharisees.
Pastor Jah, the Lord Jesus said, "But woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites! For you shut up the kingdom of heaven against men, for you neither go in yourselves, neither suffer you them that are entering to go in. God's disposition brooks no offense. You should stop trying to keep us from seeking out the work of Almighty God in the last days.
Yes.
Repent, confess your sins to God. Otherwise, your end will be the same as the Pharisees. No one can bear the sins of rejecting God.
You!
Yeah.
Don't try to scare me with what happened to the Pharisees.
Right.
If you leave to learn more, I'll expel you right now.
Expel.
Expel us? We reject you right
brother.
Now. You're just a hypocrite. Out of my way.
Brother,
I only want
brother,
to seek the
back.
True way.
Bye-bye, Pharisees.
Hey, brother.
Don't bother to expel us either. Let's go hear about Almighty God's work in the last days right
sister.
Now.
Okay.
Brothers,
sister.
Wait for us.
Hey,
sister.
Come
sister.
Back.
Well, they're gone.
What are you staring at? Go after them.
Brothers, sisters, you've gone off script. Come back here.
Hey! Why did everyone leave?
This sketch was a warning from history, but history repeated itself. I really can't follow these Pharisees anymore. I want to learn about Almighty God's work in the last days. Hey, wait for me!
Thank the Lord. Brothers and sisters stayed is fine. When they hear there is a congregation, they'll all want to come.
Ha 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 ha!
Brothers and sisters, shall we start?
Absolutely.
This hymn is so exciting. One can tell it's the voice of God.
That is correct. God is the sower and the reaper. All the sowing and reaping are done by God himself.
The fact that we can hear God's voice and welcome the Lord's return is the mercy and grace of God.
Yes. Thank God. Thank God.
We are so blessed.
We're so blessed.
Yes.
We're so blessed.
Thank God.
Brothers and sisters, we have just listened to the hymn of God's word, God is the beginning and the end. Everyone is happy and excited now, feeling that this is God's voice and expression.
Yeah.
Amen.
This is enough to prove that God's sheep will recognize the voice of God.
Amen.
Now, everyone can confirm in their heart that the word of Almighty God is God's voice. Almighty God is the returned Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Thanks be to God.
Some brothers and sisters still may not understand the truth of incarnation, so it's hard for them to stand firmly on the true way.
Yes, that is true.
Let's talk more about the truth of incarnation.
Yes, fine.
Let's read several passages of the Word of Almighty God first. Almighty God says, "The meaning of incarnation is that God appears in the flesh, and he comes to work among man of his creation in the image of a flesh. So, for God to be incarnated, he must first be flesh. Flesh with normal humanity, this, at the very least, must be true. In fact, the implication of God's incarnation is that God lives and works in the flesh. God, in his very essence, becomes flesh, becomes a man.
Amen.
The Christ with normal humanity is a flesh in which the Spirit is realized, possessing normal humanity, normal sense, and human thought. Being realized means God becoming man, the Spirit becoming flesh. To put it plainly, it is when God himself inhabits a flesh with normal humanity, and through it expresses his divine work. This is what it means to be realized or incarnated.
Amen.
So only this is incarnation.
The incarnate God is called Christ. And Christ is the flesh donned by the Spirit of God. This flesh is unlike any man that is of the flesh. This difference is because Christ is not of flesh and blood, but is the incarnation of the Spirit. He has both a normal humanity and a complete divinity. His divinity is not possessed by any man. His normal humanity sustains all his normal activities in the flesh, while his divinity carries out the work of God himself. Be it his humanity or divinity, both submit to the will of the Heavenly Father. The substance of Christ is the Spirit, that is, the divinity. Therefore, his substance is that of God himself. This substance will not interrupt his own work. And he could not possibly do anything that destroys his own work. Nor would he ever utter any words that go against his own will.
Amen.
Indeed, it's true.
Brother Zhang, allow me to read.
Okay.
God become flesh is called Christ. And so, the Christ that can give people the truth is called God. There is nothing excessive about this, for he possesses the substance of God and possesses God's disposition and wisdom in his work that are unattainable by man.
Amen.
Those who call themselves Christ, yet cannot do the work of God, are frauds.
True.
Christ is not merely the manifestation of God on earth, but instead the particular flesh assumed by God as he carries out and completes his work among mankind. This flesh is not one that can be replaced by just any man, but one that can adequately bear God's work on earth and express the disposition of God and well represent God and provide man with life.
Amen. Amen. Well, let's conclude the reading of God's words. Brothers and sisters, as believers of the Lord, although we know that the Lord Jesus is the incarnation of God, no one can really understand the truth of incarnation. Then Almighty God has come in the last days and unveiled the mystery of the truth of incarnation.
Thank God.
In the five passages of Almighty God's word we just read, Almighty God has clearly explained the truth and mystery of incarnation. Simply put, incarnation is the Spirit of God materialized in the flesh of a person. It is the Spirit of God wearing an ordinary, normal human flesh that appears and works among mankind.
Amen. Amen.
So only this is incarnation.
Right. Yes, it is.
In the age of grace, God became flesh as the Lord Jesus to do the redemptive work. In the age of kingdom, God is incarnated as Almighty God to do judgment work in the last days.
Amen.
Amen.
On both occasions of God's incarnation, we can see that not only does the incarnate God have normal humanity, he also has complete divinity. Anyone can feel the normal humanity of the incarnate God. It is not supernatural at all. He eats and lives as an ordinary person with normal emotions.
Indeed.
In the naked eye, man can't see the complete divinity of God in the flesh. Only from the work performed by God and the truth he expresses, the wisdom he reveals, and what he has and is, can it be confirmed.
Amen.
Judging from the outside, the incarnation of God is a normal, ordinary person. That is not lofty or supernatural at all. Yet the essence of the incarnate God is divinity. So Christ can express the truth, express God's disposition and what God has and is anytime and anywhere. He can do God's own work. This is what no one can do, possess, and reach.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
I'm learning so much.
Christ expresses God's word and carries out God's work within his normal humanity. What people see is a person who works and speaks. Very practical and very real. It is similar to the incarnate Lord Jesus, who appeared as an ordinary person externally, who actually lived among people.
Amen.
But the Lord Jesus has expressed many truths and given man the way of repentance.
Amen.
The Lord Jesus forgave the sins of man and expressed God's loving and merciful disposition.
Amen.
The Lord Jesus also showed many miracles and marvels, such as calming the wind and sea, feeding 5,000 people with 5 loaves and 2 fish, and raising people from the dead.
Yeah.
Which fully revealed the power and authority of God. In the end, the Lord Jesus completed the redemption work for mankind through his crucifixion.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
This makes us see that the words and work of the Lord Jesus are God's own words and work. The Lord Jesus is the incarnate God.
Amen. Amen.
That is amazing. I'm so
happy. That is so true.
As we talk about this, is everyone understanding more on how to know about the incarnation of God?
Yes.
Thank God. We understand more now.
In order to understand the incarnation of God, we must know how to listen to the voice of God and see God's disposition, wisdom, and omnipotence, what God has and is from Christ's words and work. So we can be certain that this is completely the work and word of the incarnate God.
Amen. Amen.
Do you all agree?
Yes.
That's amazing.
Thank God.
Thank God. I understand more.
Almighty God indeed reveals the mystery and truth of incarnation. Without the word expressed by Almighty God in the last days, we corrupt mankind wouldn't be able to understand the truth of incarnation, regardless of how long we've believed
indeed,
in the Lord Jesus. No one can comprehend the mystery and truth of incarnation.
Yes, that's true. That's really true.
Yes. On the outside, the incarnate Almighty God is an ordinary person who actually lives among people, not supernatural at all.
Yeah.
But Almighty God has expressed all the truths for cleansing and saving mankind, revealing all the truths and mysteries of God's management plan. and carrying out the work of judgment beginning with the house of God in the last days.
Amen.
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 Thank the Lord.
He's great.
From the word of Almighty God, we understand the purpose of God's management plan, the meaning and purpose of God's salvation work for mankind in three stages. The mystery of God's incarnation, the inside story of the Bible, and we also understand how Satan has corrupted mankind, the essence and truth of man's corruption by Satan, as well as how God saves mankind, the significance of God's judgment work in the last days, how God does judgment work for the cleansing and salvation of man, how God determines the outcomes and destinations of various kinds of people according to their types, how the kingdom of Christ is fulfilled on earth, and so on.
Amen.
God has expressed so many truths.
Think about it. Other than God, who could have expressed so much and revealed God's own mystery?
Only God.
Who can determine the outcomes and destinations of mankind? Who can do the judgment work in the last days for the cleansing and salvation of men?
Only God.
Exactly. Only God can do this type of work.
Yes.
Only the incarnate God can actually work like this to save men.
Amen.
This is the work performed by God in heaven as incarnate.
Amen.
Thank God. It really is true.
The truth of incarnation seems simple enough, but particularly profound. The simple part is, those who believe in the Lord Jesus acknowledge that the Lord Jesus is the incarnate God. The profound part is, of those who believe in the Lord for years, no one can recognize that the Lord Jesus is God's own manifestation. In the last days, God has become flesh and expressed so many truths. Who could know that the Lord Jesus has returned?
No.
And who could confirm that only Christ is able to deliver the truths for the salvation of mankind, to reveal all the mysteries of God's management plan?
No one.
Indeed, no one.
Someone like that has yet to be found in the religious community.
Yes.
It's very true.
Upon contact, man can clearly see the humanity of Christ. Man can even produce notions anytime, anywhere, due to his normal humanity. However, many people cannot understand the essence of Christ's divinity.
Yes.
Yes.
Therefore, when the Lord Jesus returns in the flesh to do his judgment work, even those who have believed in the Lord for many years could still resist and betray him.
This is a fact.
Now that we have read the Word of Almighty God and understood the truth of incarnation, the more we read the Word of Almighty God and experience His work, the more we can identify that the words expressed by Almighty God are the truth.
Amen.
Right.
And are God's disposition and what God has and is.
Amen.
Almighty God's expression is sufficient to prove that Almighty God is the advent of the Spirit of truth.
Yes.
Almighty God is the manifestation of the only true God.
Amen. Amen.
I'm so happy. Right.
You guys, thanks. I think I'm going to study when I get home. Yes, I'll read more of this.
Thanks be to God.
I wrote a lot.
After reading the Word of Almighty God and listening to the testimonies of our brothers, our eyes have really been opened.
Yes, they have.
Almighty God has indeed revealed all the truths and mysteries of incarnation. It wasn't until today did I see judgment work done by Almighty God in the last days has completely fulfilled all the prophecies made by the Lord Jesus in the Bible.
Amen.
The incarnation of God is indeed a huge mystery.
It really is.
It is easy for those who love the truth to accept the incarnate God. Those who do not love the truth are most likely to condemn and resist the incarnate God. The only way to know whether he is the incarnate God is if he can express all the truth. Other than Christ, no one else can express the truth.
Amen. Amen.
Only he who can express the truth and express the voice of God and do the work of God is the incarnate God. This is what I wasn't seeing clearly until today.
Thanks be to God.
Thank God.
It was the Word of Almighty God that enlightened me, and God graced me. Had I not read His Word, I would never have been able to ascertain that Almighty God is the second coming of the Lord Jesus. I would still be deceived and bound by the religious pastors and elders, living in the darkness like a blind person. unable to hear God's voice and see God's appearance. I finally see it clearly now. In waiting for the Lord, we should find a Son of Man who can express the truth.
Amen. Amen.
Find a Son of Man who has endured many hardships and rejection by generations for his trouble in expressing God's voice and doing God's work.
That is true.
That's right.
If we found the Son of Man, we would be meeting the Lord, and we would be brought before the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Today, I have finally found the Son of Man, who is Almighty God.
Amen. Amen.
I'm sure that Almighty God is a returned Lord Jesus, one and the same.
Amen.
Amen.
This is really the grace of God to me. I am beholden to Almighty God.
Thank God.
Thank God.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God. In the past, I didn't understand the truth about incarnation, so I was living within my imagination, assuming that the incarnate God should be magnificent in bearing and imposingly majestic, with a thunderous voice and awe-inspiring appearance that discouraged any human attempt to approach him, unbounded by time and space. He is able to appear and vanish at will and walk through walls, just like the spiritual body of Lord Jesus. Only that would be the incarnate God. In retrospect, my imagination was absurd.
We used to think that way.
I only understand what incarnation is after reading the Word of God. Incarnation is the Spirit of God realized in the flesh as an ordinary person to do God's own work.
Amen.
Just like the Lord Jesus, he's not lofty or supernatural. He actually lives among the people, expressing the truth by speaking and working in normal humanity to provide for man. In the eyes of the people, he is particularly practical and normal.
Indeed.
No wonder the Pharisees and all of those who didn't love the truth couldn't accept the Lord Jesus. Yeah. Whenever he was mentioned, they would often say, "Isn't that a carpenter's son? Isn't that a Nazarene?"
Yeah.
So it seems that even if those who do not love the truth believed in the name of Lord Jesus, they only believe in the three words, the Lord Jesus.
True.
And they do not know the Lord Jesus' divine substance. How can those who don't know the Lord Jesus accept God incarnate in the last days? No wonder many religious leaders and all of those who don't love the truth so persistently resist and condemn Almighty God.
That's true.
Yes, indeed. Yes, it is. It is Almighty God who unveiled the truth and mystery of incarnation. If we only listened to the preaching of the pastors and elders, we would never understand what God's incarnation is all about. Exactly, yes.
When we prayed to the Lord Jesus in the past, we used to pray to God the Father at the same time in fear of missing one of them. It was exactly because we didn't know about the incarnation of God.
Right.
The word of Almighty God is so great, which has so thoroughly explained the truth. It has enlightened my heart.
Thank God.
This is like attending a feast in the kingdom of heaven.
Amen.
Thank God.
Thank the Lord.
Amen. This is just so amazing. We'll finally be raptured when we accept the incarnate Almighty God.
Amen.
Our hopes and dreams have materialized.
Amen. Amen.
We thank Almighty God.
Thank God.
Amen.
Thank God.
Praise
thank
the Lord.
God.
It is God's grace.
Indeed. That's right.